A great, lively debate. It's a good week to be having this meeting because this week marks the 70th anniversary of the formation of the post-war Labour government and all of the big things that it did to change society. But you know, while that should be a moment for pride in the Labour Party, and it is to me, you've also got to ask a question. And the question I ask is this: could the modern Labour Party have created the National Health Service?
Yeah.
And I would conclude that it couldn't, having lived and worked within it for the last few years. I've seen it become more and more timid, speaking in sound bites. It's become a party that has become about managerial politics, retail politics, and it's lost its heart and soul. And that's the problem. That is the problem. So the first question is, when you think of the leader, has this man got a vision? I want to tell you what mine is. The Labour Party needs to think big again, to dare to dream. If we're to tackle the issues that have been raised in this room tonight, we need a much bigger vision next time than we had last time. So here's mine: a truly comprehensive education system that leaves no child behind, a decent home for everyone to rent or to own, for everyone, a national health and care service that supports people with mental health problems, dementia, autism, as well as it treats cancer. That, to me, is a Labour vision for the 21st century worth getting behind and worth voting for. The last point I'll make to you tonight, though, is it's not just about the policies. You've got to think about the person. And I went to Anfield in 2009 as a government minister, culture secretary, on the 20th anniversary of the Hillsborough disaster. And I'm afraid that day I was representing an out-of-touch government that hadn't been listening to the people of a Labour city. It was so close to vested interests in the media that it couldn't hear a whole city that had been crying injustice. So the question is, was I a career politician who carried on towing the Westminster line? Or was I true to the people where I grew up, who put me where I am? Well, I went back to Westminster and I took on the establishment and finally got things moving for them. And I just want you to think about that. If you elect me to be leader of the Labour Party, I won't change. That is the man that you'll be electing, somebody who's always been true to his roots, true to the people who put me in politics, and true to those Labour values, to speak up for those, the voiceless, the vulnerable, the dispossessed. That is me, that is Andy Burnham. I ask for your support in this leadership contest. Thank you very much.